I'm Erin Silva, assistant professor and a state extension specialist in organic agriculture at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Here in Wisconsin, we've been working on refining the organic no-till soybean technique for the last 7 years, and we've had great success using the roller crimper to do organic no-till soybeans. One of the questions I get from farmers, though, is there any way to push up the planting date on organic no-till soybeans rather than waiting till early June when rye reaches maturity at anthesis, when it's most effective to use the roller crimper to terminate the rye? To answer the question if an earlier soybean planting date would impact final yields in the organic no-till system, we set up a series of experiments. Instead of waiting until anthesis, the stage of rye maturity where the rye is flowering and we get effective termination of the rye cover crop, we instead came in earlier when the rye was just past the boot stage and planted the soybean directly into the standing rye using a 30-inch corn planter. After planting, we let the soybean emerge, came through to about the first trifoliate stage, and then rolled crimped about 3 weeks after soybean planting, again waiting until the rye reached anthesis, where we get effective termination and that rye stays down as a nice thick mat to suppress weeds. To do a comparable experiment, we waited until the rye reached anthesis and then planted like we typically would, rolling down the rye first and then coming in behind with a 30-inch corn planter and planting directly into that rolled mulch. Here beside me, we see the results of that experiment. On my right, we see where we've planted earlier, coming in on May 15th and planting the soybean into the standing rye. On my left, to compare, we see that later planting date, waiting until we roll or crimp, and then planting into that rolled crimp mulch instead. So between my left and my right, we have about a 3 week difference in the planting date of the soybean. Looking at these two treatments on September 2nd, we see that both treatments result in good weed management. We have some pretty weed-free fields behind me here. And both treatments as well resulted in comparable soybean stands. While the initial results of both approaches seem promising, we have about another month and a half before we're able to harvest the soybean and see the yields of the early versus later planting dates. To get that update and future updates, you can visit my website, uworganic.wisc.edu.